Welcome to Wager Talk TV. I am Kelly Stewart, joined by Dave Koken and Adam Trigger of WagerTalk.com. All right, we're going to the AAC, and we've got a Cincinnati team who's dropped four straight against the number versus an SMU team that's kind of showed some promise this year, Adam. They were on my long list to make my parlay, but opening number 12.5. It is down to 11.5. I wasn't sure they could win this game outright. Your thoughts on the Mustangs at the Bearcats?
Kel, I don't think there's any chance they win this game outright. And I actually don't really think it's going to be a close game, or at least as close as what the market's suggesting here with the move from 12.5 back to 11.5. So SMU was kind of in the mix with Houston and Cincinnati up until a couple weeks ago. They lose a heartbreaker to Houston, and then they probably lost that game again the next week against Memphis. That was a pretty big letdown spot for them. However, just from watching those games and seeing them play Houston, I thought they were second best in the Houston game the entire time, even until they lost at the end. It's kind of told me that they're not quite in the same class as Cincinnati and Houston. And I would actually probably just put Cincinnati in the class of their own, 10-0. If they win out, they really have a sort of a right to one of those college football playoff spots. So I think this Cincinnati team is far superior to SMU. And of course, Kel, we talk about this all the time. SMU is the square dog here. So they're the underdog that's attracting the public action. Always something I like to fade if I can. I'm not someone that typically lays big numbers, but I actually would have probably made this minus 14. I see Cincinnati as a two-touchdown winner, if not more. Desmond Ridder, NFL quarterback. This guy's just really good. And this Cincinnati offense can, in my opinion, score at will in this game. SMU is improving defensively. There are some redeeming qualities in this defense, but they still give up way too many big plays, in my opinion. And then finally, Cincinnati, the last month, they haven't covered a spread, as you said, in over a month. They're 0-4 against the spread in their last four games. But the magnitude of game for them just went way up playing SMU here. The last four games for them have been all, they could have won pretty much won all of those with their eyes closed. I think they know that it's going to take at least some sort of effort to beat SMU, because SMU still is a quality football team. I expect Cincinnati to be ready to play. I think that this is, sort of where they're going to make their statement. They've got two games and the AAC title game left to prove that they belong in that top four. So I think Cincinnati takes care of SMU here, and I think they're going to do it by at least two touchdowns.
Dave, I have a two-part question for you. I know you and I spoke earlier in the week, and you said you didn't have a strong opinion on this game. First part of the question is, what did you make this game, points-wise? And the second one is, how in the hell do we quantify these style points that everybody seems to think that Cincinnati has to have to get in the college football playoff?
Well, I don't think they need the style points anymore. I think that was true earlier. I kind of bought into it, and it might have cost me a couple of bets because I probably laid more than I should have against Tulane. It turned out I definitely laid more than I should have because they didn't cover. They probably shouldn't have been as big as they were against Tulsa. I think the line got about right last week against South Florida. They still didn't cover. I think the number's pretty close to right here. I made it 14, so I think there's a slight edge to Cincinnati. But they're not winning by margins right now, so I can't trust them enough to bet them. But as far as the style points go, thanks to getting help from other teams and the fact that maybe the most dangerous team that's chasing them now is Notre Dame, who they beat, I think Cincinnati simply has to win now to get in. And I hope they do, because if Cincinnati matches up against Georgia, they might not be able to make the line high enough. Georgia will kill Cincinnati. The Bearcats' interior defense is not real good, and nobody scores on Georgia. But that's down the road. As far as this game goes, I'll stay out of it. I've tasted defeat a couple of times betting on Cincinnati. I'm a little leery of doing so, but I don't see SMU with much of a chance here. And if Cincinnati does get a chance to lay the hammer to them in the fourth quarter, they might do it. So lean Cincinnati, but not a bet.
All right. Great stuff, Dave and Adam. Make sure you're following both of them on Twitter at TopFlightSI and at Dave Koken. Also, head over to WagerTalk.com. Both of these guys have up daily, weekly, and monthly, as well as season-long packages.